Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. The last lecture we talk about the Varnikis area and Brokaw area. In continuity with that last lecture, the Varnikis area and Brokaw area. Dominancy of Varnikis area in Brokaw. I told you that the right handed people, the left cerebral hemisphere is more dominant. Therefore, when a left cerebral hemisphere is dominant, the right Varnikis and Brokaw areas are dominant. When the left cerebral hemisphere is dominant, in that case, it is the right Varnikis area and Brokaw area which are dominant, and vice versa. That is when the right cerebral hemisphere is dominant, then the left Varnikis area and Brokaw area are dominant. Next, about the visual cortex, IRO, forgotten to discuss about some very important part of the visual center. Now this is area number 17, striated area. This is area number 18, parastriated area. And this is area number 19, pedistriated area. And here is the calcarei sulcus. So this is the upper lip of the calcarei sulcus. It is loaded, and calcarei sulcus is mainly on the medial surface. Here the lateral surface is formed. So the upper quadrant of retina is projected to the upper lip of calcarei sulcus. While the lower quadrant of retina is projected to the lower lip of calcarei sulcus. The upper quadrant of the retina is projected to the upper lip of calcarei sulcus, and the lower క్వాలిటీ అభివృద్ధిగా Then there is another important point, the medulla. Medulla is part of the eyeball. Suppose this is section through the eyeball. Transparent part is the cornea. This is sclera, the outer coat of the eyeball. There is a ciliary body. Ciliary body to which two structures are attained. Number one, iris, with pupil near it. Lens is suspended to the ciliary bone by suspensory ligament. Next to sclera is the choroid, heavily pigmented. Coat of the eyeball. Then there is a retina. The non-nervous retina and then the nervous retina. The neural retina. Neural retina is that retina which has rods and cones. This is the most anterior convexity of the eyeball. It is known as the anterior cone. and tearful. The most posterior convexity is called posterior bone of the eyeball. Now we jump to the posterior bone is the emergence of optic nerve. Now the part of the part of the eyeball at which the optic nerve gives, there are no rods in form, so it is known as the blind spot. Also known as optic disc. Optic disc of blind side, blind spot is not in the posterior bone, inner posterior bone. Here, just at the level of posterior bone, there is an area which can be seen with the help of ophthalmoscope, elevation curve. This elevation area which can be seen with the help of thermoscope, we get it just to the posterior pole of the eyeball, is known as macula lutea. Macula means spot. Lutea stands for yellow. You know, for it, the term uses rubra. For black, it is used macula. For yellow, lutea. Now, in the center of lutea, there is a depression. This is known as fovea centralis. So, whole yellow area is the macula lutea, but it's central for depression. The depression in the center of this macula lutea is known as fovea centralis. So what is the importance of this area? Here in the retina there are rods and cones. So as we approach the macula lutea, the number of rods it will reduce and cones increase. Cones, number of cones gradually increase and rods gradually decrease. So that the fovea centralis, there are only cones. No rods. So, macula lutea. Best image is found. Nebula. YouTube. Why? Number one. Its cortical area is more extensive. Cortical area is the more extensive. As compared to the rest of the visual center, as compared to the peripheral part of the retina. More extent. And what is the other reason? Cone density is more. This area of the eye. So this was an important point to remember. The area for macular lintel starts from the occipital core in the depth of the calcarine circle up to the lunate circle, which is the extent of the visual cortex for macula lutea. Both on the lateral and medial surface. This diagram lateral surface is shown. And here the center is calcarine surface. This is the cortical area, larger area for macula lutea. Now, the topic of today's lecture is other broad-based cortical areas. Government cortical area of cerebral hemisphere. Apart from the major areas, you know the area number 4, motor area, area number 6. Area number 8, and their sensory cortex, area number 3, area number 1, area number 2, visual cortex 17, 18, 19. Here the auditory area. The area number 41, 42, 22, and broadcast area 44. Now here in this diagram, the upper lip and lower lip of the posterior and the lateral sulcus, they are stretched upwards and downward to visualize the insula. This is insula. So, other areas, number 1, if sudaremo. In Sudaremia, you know this some kind as the circular circus of insula, circus centralis, then gyri brevis in the anterior part, and gyri longus in the posterior part. Now anterior part of insula is paramedial. Posterior part of insula is a granular. In the cerebral cortex, there are different types of neurons. Pyramidal neurons, large size, medium size, small size, giant size pyramidal cells. Then there are granule cells, satellite cells. Then there are basket cells, horizontal, so many types of neurons, differently named, which will study in detail in the historical structure of the gray matter of the cerebral cortex and also cerebellar cortex. Now, I told you this is motor cortex, area number 4. Motor cortex, and this area number 3, sensory cortex. So in the motor cortex, there are more pyramidal cells. More pyramidal cells, neurons in the cerebral cortex of area number 4. While in the sensory cortex, area number 3, there are more granule cells. So because in the motor cortex, area number 4, which types of neurons are more pyramidal type? This is why motor cortex is also known as pyramidal cortex. Second, in the sensory cortex, area number 3, which type of neurons are more? The granule cells are more. This is why the sensory cortex is also known as granular cortex. Now, what about the insular area? This is sulcus centralis, this is the anterior part and this is posterior part. So in the cerebral cortex of the anterior part of the insula, there are more pyramidal cells, just like motor cortex. While in the posterior part of the insula, there are more granule cells, just like the sensory cortex. This was briefly about structural difference of this area. Now, what is the function of this insular cortex? Experiments have shown that it is associated with connected with insular cortex is associated or connected with elementary canal. GIT. This is function of the insular cortex. Next, on the medial surface of the cerebellum segment. This is a midline structure. These are midline structure. The corpus callosum, which connect the right and left cerebellum. The cut end of the corpus callosum and the rest of the midline structures. So this is medial surface of cerebellum. This is posterior pole and this is frontal pole. Temporal pole. You know, here is the upper part is central surface. The initial part of the central surface. Then there is a surface known as the cingulate surface. This is unnamed surface. And around it, you know, it is paracentral artery. This is supraspinal sulcus, just above the level of the splenium of the corpus callosum. Then parieto-occipital sulcus, and then calcarine sulcus. And radial sulcus. And this is collateral sulcus. All these sulci and gyri we discussed in the extraorbital topics. Now here, this long gyrus, this is known as the cingulate gyrus. Cingulate gyri. And then you know here is isthmus. Then this is the parahippocampal gyri. This is the ankus, hook shaped gyri. Surrounded by radial sulcus. All these we discussed already. The external features. So other prominent cortical areas, we talk about the insular area. Now number two is cingulate area. Now cingulate area is the cingulate gland. Brahmin number area number 31, 23, and 24. This interior part, cingulate gland. This is area number 24. Area number 23, and this is area number 31. Now you can see on the medial surface, this is the medial surface of the frontal lobe, and the medial surface, the lateral surface of frontal lobe will be divided into motor area, premotor area, and prefrontal area, interior part of the superior, middle, inferior frontal gyri, prefrontal area. So on the medial surface, the interior part of the cingulate gyrus is on the medial surface of prefrontal lobe, area of the cerebral cortex. What is the function of this area? Number one, it is the one of the major parts of limbic lobe. One of the major parts of limbic lobe of cerebral hemisphere. Then and number two, this area number 24. Of cingulate gland, this one. Its function is to control pulse rate, blood pressure, blood pressure and the behavior. Mainly this area number 24, anterior part of the cingulate gland, cingulate area. This area also suppress the rage phenomenon. Rage phenomenon. You will study it in more detail in the physiology. It is the animal responsible for the gait. It is hyper excited. try to attack people's targeted, shooting, ears up, erected, and then try to attack instead of running. It's a rare phenomenon. So one of the important functions of this is to suppress the rare phenomenon. And this you will study in physiology in detail. Then it is also seen that when the connections of area, interior part of the singular area, especially area number 24, experimentally are in the patients, when connections of area number 24 are cut, and what happens? Fear and anxiety are lost. Fear and anxiety of the individual is lost. He or she does not become anxiety. No fear. When these connections are lost. Connections of singulate area, especially area number 24. So in other areas, first we talk about the insular area, then we talk about the cingulate area, then there are areas which are called the suppressor areas. There are some areas which suppress the activity, inhibit the activity. Now, what are these? Area number 4S. You know, this is area number 4, motor area, the lateral surface of the post-central gyrus. Now, small lower interior part of the area number 4. Small lower interior part of the pre-central gyrus, area number 4. This is numbered by Brahman as area number 4S. It is part of the area number 4. Because it suppresses, so it is known as area number 4S. Then areas number 6, area number 8, area number 2, area number 19. These are suppressor areas. So, very easy to remember. This is area number 4. And the next number, area 6 and 8. So, area number 4S. Then the last number, area number 6 and 8. Not area number 4. 4S. Then you know, sensory cortex, area number 3, 1 and 2. The last one, area number 2, it is suppressor area. Now come to the visual cortex, area number 17, 18, 19, which is the last one, area number 17, area number 19, is included in the suppressory areas, which suppress the motor and sensory activity. Next, extrapyramidal areas of cerebral cortex. I told you the motor system is the corticospinal types, parallel types, and the other motor system is extrapyramidal. So in the cerebral cortex, there are some areas which are related to the extrapyramidal system. So what are these areas? Just repetition of these. Again, area number 4S also acts as extrapyramidal area. Area number 6, area number 8, area number 2. Area number 19. Same suppressor areas also act as extra pyramidal areas of cerebral cortex. Now, we just finished with the broadband cortical areas of the cerebral cortex. Now, the brain is spinal cord is blood supply, which is very important. So, blood supply of the brain is spinal cord, we will discuss later on in the training. But there are some very important centers. For example, the paracentral lobe is very important. Area number 468, anterior or sensory area 312, because it is related to the external genital area sphincter, apart from foot length. So it is very important. So you should know the blood supply of paracentral lobe. Second, the Broca's area 44-45, motor speech area. Similarly, here is auditory area 41, 42, and 22. And then here is the visual center, visual area. So what is the blood supply of some of these very important areas? Because when these areas are discussed, so the examiner will also ask the blood supply of these areas. And blood supply of the brain or supply we discuss later on in detail. But here, briefly, we will talk about the blood supply of these, some of the important broadband cortical areas. This is the posterior ramus of the lateral surface. The post-central sulcus, the central sulcus, You separate the motor cortex from the sensory cortex. And these remind. This is superior temporal sulcus. This is inferior temporal sulcus. And the calcalli sulcus, junior sulcus. Now there are three main arteries supply the brain. Number one, anterior cerebral artery. Cerebral. You know of midbrain. All medulla oblongata and behind it cerebellum. This is, you know, longitudinal fissure. And this is white matter and midline structure which connect the right and left serve la nostra fede. Partially separated by the longitudinal fissure. Inside is white matter, and you know this is gray matter. And within the white matter again there is a collection of gray matter in the form of nuclei. So central branches supply these nuclei. Only cortical branches supply this heavy corpus. So here, this is corpus callosum. You can see cut section of the corpus callosum. And here you can see this is the corpus callosum. This is superior surface of the corpus callosum. And you know, dural fold fox cerebra is also here. But here, through this longitudinal fissure, right and left anterior cerebral arteries are on. Right anterior cerebral artery. And this is left. Anterior cerebral artery run in the floor of the longitudinal fissure. And in this view you can see this is the anterior cerebral artery of one side. Anterior cerebral artery. Now you know here there is very important area, paracentral lobe. Anterior part and posterior part of para. Central lobule partially separated by the central sulcus. The anterior part is the motor and posterior part is sensory, which are the supralateral surface. The anterior part is in continuity with the precentral callus. Area number 4, and the posterior part is post-central callus, area number 3. And here I told you, there are centers, motor and sensory center for genitalia. External genitalia. Sphincter of external genitalia. Urethral sphincter, anal sphincter. So, the anterior cerebral artery supply which one of the very important cortical area? That is the paracentral lobe. Is supplied by the cortical branches of anterior cerebral artery. So when these arteries are damaged or blocked, then the blood supply of the paracentral lobe will be affected and it will result in incontinence of defecation and micturition. Next is the middle cerebral artery. It runs through the वो स्टील है ना साथ लेटर समझो मिडल सेरेब्रल आगे नाउ यू नो ग्रो स्ट्रीट दिस इज ब्रोकार एरिया एरिया नंबर 44 एरिया नंबर 45 मोटर स्पीच एरिया हेयर सुपीरियर टेम्पोरल गायरस इज द ऑडिटरी एरिया क्लोज टू इट ऑडिटरी एरिया एरिया नंबर 41 एरिया नंबर 42 देन यू नो यस्टरडे वी टॉक अबाउट द ओवरनिकीज़ is also closed. One key area, area number 39 and 40, especially the angular balance. So can you see these important areas are close related with the middle cerebellum. So all these important areas is supplied by Broca's area, motor speech area, auditory area, and Fornicus area. So if the middle cerebral artery is blocked or damaged, these important centers will also be affected. Apart from it, it also supplies the lower part of the lower parts of the area number 4, area number 2. Only lower parts. Upper part by anterior cerebral artery. That will be discussed later on. This is the territory of anterior cerebral artery. The medial surface, paracentral, anterior cerebral artery, and then the supralateral surface, the upper part of the supralateral surface of the cerebellum. Branches of anterior cerebral arteries. Right. No, this is the middle cerebral artery. The most important area is supplied by branches of the middle cerebral artery, or Broca area, auditory area. Then, on the basal surface of the each cerebellum of the pair, is the right and left posterior cerebral artery. On the basal surface of the right cerebellum sphere, right posterior cerebral artery, and on the basal surface of left cerebellum sphere, left. So the middle cerebral artery cortical branches supply Broca area. Then auditory area. And then one key is in. Now posterior cerebral artery, which run posteriorly on the basal surface of right and left cerebellum on the side. Can you see visually? Supply the visual area, visual cortex, visual center, area number 17. 18 and 19. So here briefly we summarize the versicle of some very important problem cortical areas. So when the examiner will ask the different cortical areas in vivos, so along with it, he or she may ask about the blood supply of paracentral nerve, visual center, auditory center, Broca's area, Wernicke's area. But there is a separate topic of blood supply of the spinal cord that we will discuss later on in detail. Thank you very much.